Hello guys, and welcome to this video to see details of every single step of class 1 restorations, alright? So you removed the caries and you did your preparation, so there is the link for the video of preparations. And now you have two options. Either we do selective etching on the enamel, like this, or the procedure that we are going to do in this video, which is the total etching. There is even a recommended reference for you guys to see in details, a very nice article from Prof. Blatz and his team. And the next step will be, of course, to rinse with water, right? So the time of etching depends on the materials. And then we are going to do the bonding, all right? So take a look at this. This bonding material from Ultradent has the tip already for you to brush on the surface. And it's important to apply and brush, look, rub on the dentin, rub on the surface, okay? And then you can even remove the excess. If there is excess with a micro brush like this, you are just removing a little bit the excess. And then only then you are going to air dry, all right? So now you are going to air dry. Take a look at this, okay? And then you have this shining appearance, and that's correct. Now you are going to light cure, of course, and then if you light cure closer to the preparation, it's even better. It makes difference. Okay, it's already proven by the literature, so you should light cure close to the preparation. And then we are going to use this material from Ultradent as well, so the composite resin, the universal one. And we are packing now the composite resin into the cavity to do the first increment, okay? And as we pack, take a look at this. I even captured the screen to show to you guys. As you pack the material, you are going to make your instrument parallel to the surfaces of the tooth, of the cusp and everything, to make sure that you are following the anatomy. You are packing the resin and making the anatomy at the same time, okay? Removing the excess, all right? Always with your instrument parallel to the surfaces, to the existing surfaces of the tooth. And then you light cure, and then of course you go and insert the next increments. Okay, so that's the incremental technique. And take a look at this. This is a resin that you can condense, so it's a very stable resin that's very nice. Okay, if it gets a little bit dry, if you take too long, for example, doing this, then maybe even if it gets a little bit dry, you would polish your restoration later, okay? Again, the instrument is parallel to the surface of the tooth, removing the excess, okay? And also creating the anatomy of the fissures. So you create the anatomy of the sulcus, of the fissures, and at the same time, you are removing the excess, being parallel to the existing surface of the cusp, okay? So the internal surface of the cusp. And even lateral ridges, so you clean lateral ridges, and then always with your instrument parallel to the surfaces, okay? And at the same time, packing the resin inside the cavity as much as possible. All right, let's review this from a different angle, okay? Of course, you would finish light curing that last increment, but let's review first the procedure from a different view. With the tip of the instrument, you can create the sulcus or the fissures. You are going to do this at the same time as your learning curve gets developed, okay? So that's very important, right? Of course, that's a learning curve. So you can create this fissure in the middle with the tip of your instrument because the rest of your instrument is parallel to the surface. That's the recommended reference because as you light cure, every single brand of resin will change a little bit the color, and that's why you should light cure even the trial phase to make sure the color will be nice. Okay, so in some cases this will be required. But here we have a plastic tooth, right? So even though this resin adapts to the color of the tooth, we have a plastic tooth here, so just to show this tutorial to you guys, all right? So, and there you have it. Okay. So you can even, if you need, you can add more increments. Okay. And it's still removing the excess at the same time that you are creating the anatomy. All right. So just to show to you guys another increment. Okay. And now creating the final anatomy and the sulcus with the tip of the plastic instrument at the same time. All right, so that's why you should have a very nice plastic instrument as well in order to finish this. So this restoration is not polished yet, but then don't forget you're going to finish to adjust in occlusion and to polish. All right, if you guys like, please hit the like button and see you guys on the next videos.